Welcome to another edition of Math Snacks with Miss Glovely and Miss Wonderful. Today we're going to talk about elapsed time.
What's elapsed time?
You know, when you get those story problems about how long went in between, like you start this and you end here, and
how long something takes.
How long something takes. Let me show you an example.
Okay.
You've probably seen something like this in your textbooks before.
Oh, probably.
An airplane left the Newport News Williamsburg Airport at 9:50 a.m.
Okay.
You know, was that morning or night?
That would be morning.
Morning. And arrived at Detroit, Michigan at 11:45 a.m. That same morning.
Okay, great. Didn't
how
take
long?
Very long.
How
I didn't
long?
Have to be in the air very long because I'm afraid sometimes.
Okay, well, how long did that trip take, Ms. Glovely?
Well, if I were going to do this like I've seen in textbooks before, mm-hmm. I know that I'm going to use kind of a backward strategy because I'm going to start. I ended here, but that's my bigger number, so it has to come first.
Because we always subtract the smaller number from the bigger
no,
number.
No, we don't always, but in this case we would, I think.
Okay.
So then we're going to subtract from that beginning time of 9:50. And if I subtract, I can take 0 away from 5, leaves 5. And I can't take 4 away, I'm backwards talking today. 5 away from 4, so I'm going to borrow. Make that a 0 and bring over 10, which is 14. 5 from 14 is 9. And then I can't take 9 away from 0, so I'm going to borrow again and make that 10 come over.
You're really good on that borrowing and carrying.
I know, but there's
What's
a
wrong?
Problem with that.
What's wrong, Miss Glovely?
Well, there
you
are...
don't think it's an hour and 95 minutes it
well,
took?
No, because there's not 95 minutes in an hour. There's only 60 minutes in an hour, so that would be 2 hours and 35 minutes, and I don't think that's right. I think something's wrong.
2 hours. I'm going to write that. You think this converts to 2:35 because there's 60 minutes.
60 of those would be 35 left over.
But it could be 2:35 sounds kind of right, doesn't it?
Well, it might be close, but I think there's a problem. I don't like doing it with subtraction. I think there's got to be a better way.
It's kind of confusing.
It is because... Yeah, I don't think that's right.
Well,
because I know why. I know why.
Why?
Because this is using base 10 numbers and... The clock is 60 minutes,
well,
not 100 minutes.
That doesn't work.
That doesn't work.
Well, let's look at another approach.
Show me a different way. Show me a different way.
We're going to use a number line. Okay? So
I
let's
love my
look
lines.
At a number line.
Love them. Love them.
Just an open number line.
Okay.
Okay? But let's go ahead and let's think of this as time.
Oh, okay.
So we get on the plane here at 9:50.
Okay.
And we get off at 11:45.
All right.
So let's just...
Go by hours. Go by hours.
Go by hours. Okay. So 1 hour is going to be what?
10:50.
Okay. So this would be 10:50. And I'm going to write up here that we went 1 hour.
Okay.
Okay. And if I go again by an hour, what time am I?
We're at 11:50. We've already been on the ground for a while.
You've already been on the ground. You probably are just getting out of the gate. So the answer is less than 2 hours, right?
Right.
I
told you there was something wrong.
Something fishy about it. Wasn't working right, was
it? Nope, it wasn't.
So, but it's 11:50 and we went at 11:45.
Right, so you have to back up 5 minutes.
We'll go back. But if we got to take 5 minutes off that 2 hours then to get there at 11:45.
So, which makes it an hour and 55 minutes.
Because there's 60 minutes
and
in
an hour.
Hour.
I like it. I like that number line.
55 is how long.
Number lines are great.
Okay, they're a great way to look at those numbers. So I'm going to share with you just some ones that you can find for the interactive boards.
Okay.
Okay? Because this was just a naked number line.
Okay.
But we're going to do... ones that look like this. Okay?
Cool.
Okay, so what time is it here?
It is 12:15.
Okay, 12:15. And where's that at on the number line?
12:15 would be right there.
Okay.
Pin doesn't work.
It doesn't. I'm going to use red.
Okay.
12:15. And we want to know how much time it was from 12:15 to...
3:45,
okay.
Which is clear down here.
Okay, clear down here. So, we could jump by hours again.
We could, or we could actually go, since these are in 15-minute increments, you could go in 15-minute increments.
You could, but that's a lot of them to count.
That is, so let's go by hours.
Okay, so 12:15 to 1:15 is 1 hour.
Yep.
To 2:15 is 2 hours. 2 hours. 3:15 is 3 hours. And then we've got 3 hours and another 15 minutes. And a 30 minutes.
Hey, that so I like this method. That really is very cool. It's like a ruler, but it's broken up into time.
It is. That's very cool. Okay.
You and you're throwing
papers. I like to throw things.
I know.
Can I throw that too?
Oh my. There it went.
Okay, so this one's yours to time.
Okay.
What time is it?
It is 6:30, which would be right here on my starting point.
And I'm going to hold this up because it's really hard to see that 30 on there.
6:30.
It's 6:30.
And then we're going to go to...
That kind of looks like 10:45.
That's hard. That's 9:45. I can tell because that hour hand isn't quite to the 10 yet. So we're starting here, ending here. Am I going to count by hours again?
I don't know. What do you want to count by?
I think I'll count by hours. I like hours.
Okay.
And if I was doing it with my fingers, I'd do that same thing.
Okay.
So 6:30 to 7:30 is one.
Mm-hmm.
And then 7:30 to 8:30 would be two.
Mm-hmm.
And over to 9:30 would be 3 hours. And then I only have to go 15 minutes more. So 3 hours and 15 minutes.
Cool.
Is my elapsed time. I like this method.
I like it too. I just think it makes it so clear to look at and see.
It does.
So you ready to try one that's in context again?
Okay.
Back to, I'm going to give you a naked number line.
Okay.
Okay.
I think I can do it now.
Here we go. How long did John sleep if he went to bed at 9:40 p.m. and got up at 7:20 a.m.?
Okay, now you're getting tricky because now we have to go clear through the night and go past midnight.
So you're going to have to make enough room and you can only see up to about this point here.
Okay, so if we're going to start at 9:40 and I'm going to count by hours. Ooh, this is a thick pen. So this could be 10:40, 11:40, 12:40, which is just past midnight, 1:40, 2:40, 3:40, 4:40, 5:40, 6:40, and I'm going to have to move it. This would be 7:40 over here. And we don't have to go to 7:40, do we? We're going to have to back up again. So this was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, that would be 10 if I was going to clear out there, but I have to back up 20 minutes. So it's only going to be 9 hours and 40 minutes to sleep.
Now, you said you backed up 20 minutes, so why you put 40 there?
Because 7:40, this was 10 hours, 10 total hours. So if I'm backing up 20 minutes, I take 20 minutes off of the 60, and that's 40.
You know me.
You write it down.
I've got to double check.
Okay.
I'm just not quite sure I'm with you on it.
Okay, you write all those numbers out for me.
Okay.
In your nice little
handwriting. I can't do this backing up thing as well as you do. So I'm going to do this. This is 10:40, I agree.
Okay.
11:40.
That's 2 hours.
12:40.
3.
1:40.
4.
2:40. 3:40. 4:40. 5:40, 6:40, but I'm going to stop there. 6:40.
And that's 9 hours.
And I'm trying to get to 7:20, which is right here.
Right.
So if I add 20 more minutes.
You are to 7 o'clock.
I'm at 7 o'clock, and I have gone.
20 minutes.
20 minutes onto this, so I'm at 7.
And you got to go to 7:20, so it's 20 more.
20 more.
I was right!
So it's 9:40. Okay.
9 hours and 40 minutes.
I wish I could get that kind of sleep.
Me too. It doesn't ever happen. It
doesn't happen at my house.
Me neither.
But anyhow. Well, that was a neat way of looking at how we can work on elapsed time in a different way than what we always see in our textbooks.
Cool. I like it.
And understand it. So, well, thank you for joining Miss Glovely and Miss Wonderful on another episode of Math Snacks. If you're interested in more information about Math Snacks, or you'd like to bring Miss Glovely or Miss Wonderful to your classroom, call Miss Glovely, Renee Smith, at 620-663-9566.